What's up, everybody? I hope you had a good Easter. Now it's time to jump back into our teaching about Psalm 91. Today we'll be taking a look at Psalm 91, verse 4. And this verse gives us a great example about what it means for God to be our protector. Okay, listen up. I'm gonna tell you something. Please, don't tell anybody, all right? When I was a kid, I used to be scared of the dark. Listen, don't laugh. Don't laugh at me, okay? Everybody is scared of something. And I remember being in my room and I would be so terrified, and I just thought that everything around me was going to turn into a monster or something and come out and just grab me. So one thing that I used to do was get under my cover and pull the cover over my head. And I used to feel like with the cover being over my head, I had a special force field that would protect me from all of the monsters that were in my room in the dark who were reaching out to just grab me. Now, I don't know about you, but I feel safe when I'm covered by something that is protecting me from the dangerous things that are around me. Our Bible verse for today says that God will cover you with his feathers and he will protect you with his wing. Or it says that under his wing, you will find refuge. I know, I hear you. You're probably sitting there scratching your head going, wait a minute, God has feathers? God has wings? That doesn't even make sense. No worries. Not to my knowledge anyway, God does not have feathers and God does not have wings. But this is the example that I talked about at the beginning of the video. When birds have little baby chicks, there are a lot of things in nature that could possibly harm those little chicks. So what the bird does is the bird puts its feathers or its wings around the baby chicks to cover them and protect them from all of the dangerous things that may try to come up and harm it. So you can think about bad weather or other animals that may try to come and hurt the little birdies. This is exactly what God does for us. You see, God knows that we are surrounded by things that can potentially harm us. So what he does is he provides us with a special place of protection. Not only that, but when we find ourselves in that special place of protection, or we find ourselves when we are covered by God, God will not only cover us, but he's going to take care of us at the same time. For example, right now we're dealing with the coronavirus. So our special place of protection or our covering is in the safety of our homes with our families, with the people who love us the most. We should be thankful that we are healthy and we have food to eat and we have a place to stay. Listen, we should be thankful that we can still go to the grocery store and buy groceries. We should be thankful that we have some really smart people who are working really hard to try to figure out what needs to be done to stop this virus. And we should be thankful that, hey, Amazon is still delivering packages. There are so many people working so hard to make sure that you and I are taken care of. And at the same time, God is covering us. God is protecting us. God is keeping us safe. If you don't remember anything else that I said in this video, you have to remember this. God, your God, our God, is working really hard behind the scenes to make sure that you are protected. And he's working really hard behind the scenes to make sure that someone is taking really good care of you. Okay? Peace out.